Hi everybody, in this tutorial today we will see some advanced query on MongoDB array. Actually now I will follow a different way. As you can see, it's my mega menu in my website and it's my drop down menu as well as and these are my drop down menu, these are my mega menu, my simple menu. Okay, so I have implemented this array in my Node.js OneStack project. So I will use this query to implement how we can edit this category or subcategory here. So let me show you. If I add a simple menu, then it will be added. As you can see, if I click, it will be deleted, and if I edit, it will be SD. Okay, now as you can see, it has. So let me show you my database design. As you can see, take my video. Okay, my video is working well, my recording is working well. As you can see, this is my model. I have a type of string and category name string and a subcategory array. We will see array manipulating using this subcategory. We will enter our subcategory, edit, delete, etc. Then it will be more clear to you. Okay, suppose let me check my database here. As you can see, this is my menu database document. Okay, here as you can see, I have three part, as I show you in my model: subcategory, category name, and type. And if it is simple menu, it is subcategory will be empty, and it's drop down menu, it's will have some subcategory. It is mega menu, it will have also some subcategory. Okay, so now what we should do, we will see how we can add a embedded document. Actually these are the documents into a array. Let me show you the query. This query will be available in menus. Okay, so we want to add a menu and add a subcategory in my subcategory array. I just need to follow part. Okay, let me copy this, and if I this here, and let me make it clear to you. So okay, so to add a subcategory in my subcategory array, I just need to select the category name. Actually suppose if I want to add in this category name pages, I just need to pages here, control category name pages, as these are dynamic in my Node.js project, but here I should use static. Okay, and I have to select, I have to use push to add the subcategory in subcategory. And what I would like to push, I would like to push I would like to push a new name. Okay, and the name new name. Run this query, it will add a new name into my pages subcategory in my this document, the pages subcategory. Let me run this query. As you can see, it is showing that it has added one in our pages subcategory. Take pages and new name. as I didn't add any ID, it added to my pages subcategory. So what was our query? I use update one and I select this category and I push. Okay, quite well. If you push, it will be added to your array. Now let me show you how to edit a array element. Okay, I just demonstrated with this query. So demonstrate, I need this I will use update one and category name page and set category name new category as it was not our backend, and then our pages will be new category. Let me run this query. As you can see, it is showing doing well. Now if I run this, as you can see, my pages category will be new category. So this is how we have updated our category. But if we want to update this subcategory, how we can update array with a category? I have also some routes here and some edit subcategory. It's also quite easy. Then you just have to do this query into your collection. Let me explain this how we can add edit. We just to select the subcategory name. Let me edit this page one. Controls. Set subcategory dot dollar. This dollar sign, the projection operator. I used here to set my where subcategory dot name page and the subcategory dot name new subcategory. Okay, one will be replaced with new subcategory. So demonstrate how to update our array, embedded array. Run this. It is updating my. Let me show, check. As you can see, it is updating my subcategory where my category is new category. Okay. So this is how I can update, and we can also delete our subcategory. Delete subcategory one. Just go. Let me select the collection. Control subcategory dot name subcategory, and if I pull this, this will delete this subcategory from this subcategory. Okay, subcategory. If I run this returning true, that means if I check out, it will delete this subcategory right now. Okay, from the new category. Okay, it has been deleted. But it is not doing. Category dot name page one. Do I have any page one? Actually, I don't have any page one. I have to select this subcategory and subcategory. Okay. Now we run my query. As you can see, new subcategory has been old from my subcategory array. So this is how we can delete, edit and insert. And obviously the common use in embedded array of MongoDB array. And we can also various array but I will do